In this video, I will show you how to make any decorative object into an IoT smart device. I chose a plant pot to make it smart, and I'll turn it into a device that sends motion notifications. We will use an ESP01 Wi-Fi module for wireless communication and a few components for the circuit. We will also be using a free service for notifications. You can make different projects using the methods you will see in this project, so let's get started. The ESP8266 is a Wi-Fi module great for IoT and home automation projects. Comparing the ESP8266 with other Wi-Fi solutions on the market, it is a great option for most Internet of Things projects. For this project, we're going to use a free service called IFTTT that stands for If This Then That. This service is used to automate a wide variety of tasks online. In this case, we will get a notification when the sensor detects motion. Go to the IFTTT webpage and click the Get Started button. Complete your details and create your account. After that, click the Create New Applet button. Click the If This Add button and search for the Webhook service. The Webhook service allows you to integrate other services on IFTTT with your DIY projects via simple web requests. You need to type in an event name like Smart Plant Pot. Click the Create Trigger button. Now press the Then That, Add and search for the notification service. This action will send a notification to your devices from the IFTTT app. Type the message you want to be displayed on the notification screen. Finally, press the Create Action button. You should have your applet created after clicking Continue and Finish. Now, let's get the API key that we will add to the source code. Go to Webhooks from My Services. Click the Documentation tab. Here you can find your unique API key that you must keep private. Copy your unique API key to use in the code. First, open the source code link from the video descriptions. I suggest you use the Arduino web editor for editing. Thus, details such as adding a library will not take your time. Replace with your event name and API key in the code. Source code does not need any other changes. We will do the wireless network connection later easily. Now the code is ready to be uploaded to the ESP01. We will need a programmer module. For this, we will use the FTDI module. The FTDI serial converter module is used as a power source and to program the ESP01. When connecting to an ESP01, the working voltage of the FTDI converter module needs to be set to 3.3 volts. Connect the module to the ESP01 as shown in the circuit diagram. Then, plug the module into the computer with a USB cable. Now, we select the ESP01 and the connected port from the board section of the editor and click Upload. The uploading may take some time. This is normal. Now, we have the ESP01 Wi-Fi module ready for our project. I built and tested the circuit on a breadboard. The circuit is as complex as it looks, so I designed a PCB to make it fit for the project. If you don't want to use a PCB, you can still make this project by assembling the circuit on a breadboard. The next steps will be the same for both. I used browser-based software to design the circuit and PCB. Designing a circuit works like in any other circuit software tool. You place some components and you wire them together. Then you assign each component to a footprint. Then you place each component. When you're happy with the layout, you make all the connections and route your PCB. Then you export the Gerber file for the PCB order. So, how to order PCB? Go to PCBWay website. PCBWay is a full-feature printed circuit board manufacturing service. Then, open the PCB instant quote page. Use the Quick Order PCB. Press the Add Gerber File button to upload the provided Gerber files. You can increase your PCB order quantity and change the solder mask color. I've ordered the blue color. Then, order boards for approximately $5. The shipping cost will vary depending on your country. Once you're ready, you can order the PCBs by clicking Save to Cart and complete your order. The next step is soldering the components to the PCB. Don't worry, we will not use SMD components, so soldering will be easy. I'll first start by soldering the ESP01 Wi-Fi module. I did not use headers to keep the card size small, but you can use female header pins. We will use an electrolytic and a ceramic capacitor to smooth the voltage peaks. The capacitors prevent unexpected resets or unstable behavior for your ESP8266. The ESP recommended operating voltage is 3.3 volts, so you'll need a voltage regulator. Add a status LED to observe the program progress. Then, I add a battery buckle to power the board. Also, I left two pins for those who want to use an on-off switch. Finally, I add the mini motion sensor that will detect the motion and trigger the system. We have completed the soldering. In the next step, we will assemble the board into the plant pot. We use the Wi-Fi Manager library in the source code. Wi-Fi Manager allows you to connect your ESP8266 to different access points without having to hard code and upload new code to your board. Your ESP will automatically join a known network or set up an access point that you can use to configure the network credentials. After establishing a connection with ESP, you will be directed to a web page that allows you to configure your SSID and password. When a new SSID and password is set, ESP restarts and the connection is complete. Finally, download the IFTTT application and install it. Sign into your IFTTT account and turn on notifications. I hope this project was interesting and you can apply these concepts to your own home automation projects. Thanks for watching.